In today's video, I will be doing the first ear of the Australian Shepherd. I hope you guys enjoy. So let's get started. Getting rid of these lines that I've marked for the darker fur. And going back in. Alright, going in with cold gray one next. And with this, I'm just going to go around the edge where the dark fur meets the brown fur. Keeping an eye on the fur direction. Going back in with warm gray one for up here. How was everyone's holiday? Did y'all have a good holiday? Going in with cold gray one again. Okay, going in again with warm gray one. Turning my pencil around every once in a while to keep that sharp point. And there's a little bit of loose hairs here, so I'm just going in with warm gray one to put those in. Alright, so with cold gray one, I'm just going to put that down as my base for the dark areas of the ear. going in with my beige red next. And I'm just going to go around the tip of the ear. I'm going in with small circular motions with this color to map in the areas that will be the brown fur. Bring it up. You can start seeing where I put the embossing lines down with the nail dotting tool. Going up around the edge of the ear here as well with beige red, light touch, small circles. Kind of bringing it into the dark fur. Again, nice light touch. And a little bit here as well. Tad bit. And the fur that flicks up. Here as well. Going in with cinnamon, and I'm just going to go in the darker areas of the ear. Very lightly, just kind of going in a back and forth motion. The fur here is a little bit longer, so I'm doing longer strokes. Mm-hmm. clicking towards myself. This part. Looking towards the ear here. Sticking out here, just going in with terracotta, and I'm going to it's kind of like glaze the color on top, but I'm also putting in some fur strokes. Just going back and forth. Some flicks I'm going towards the ears, and some are going away. Down here. The fur around the ear is a little messy, so don't need to really worry that much about fur strokes. Just trying to give it a messy hair look. And then up here as well. You can kind of see a little bit of brown peeking through the dark fur. So we'll add some terracotta up here to give it that look. Going in with burnt ochre next, and darkening up again, always going light to dark. using longer flicks for the fur here. Using slightly harder pressure here. I'm gonna go in with burnt sienna next and just add in some details. Okay, and so I'm actually using the tip of the pencil here more than the side to get a sharper, crisper line, crisp line. I'm using the lines that I put down with my nail dotting tool kind of as a reference to where the sienna should go down. I'm using the side of my pencil of my burnt sienna, and I'm just going to glaze over to give it a little bit more of a brown tint to the fur here. So when I put my grays and black on top. And there's some flyaway fur around the edge of the ear, so I'm gonna add a little bit of the burnt sienna into the darker spots, like the underside. Okay. Next color is gonna be Nouget. And with Nouget, I'm going to just turn my page here, keeping it in frame. I'm helping with flyaways. Again, helping with the flyaway fur. Looking a little funny right now, but we are going to work through it. And what I'm going to do next is put warm gray 3 down into the dark part of the ear. Again, overlapping into the brown. Using the side of my pencil when close to the brown, just glazing the color on top. Still using the side of my pencil and just going in the center of the ear slightly, leaving a few areas lighter since that is what I see in the reference photo. I'm gonna take this gray and bring it up slightly. Here. going to go in with dark sepia now. And for dark sepia, I'm actually just going to put it down in areas that I can see that are the darkest in the ear. And bringing it out into, again, the brown of the fur. I'm going to be jumping around for this part. So, for here, I'm going to be a little bit more precise. And a flick in the ear here. And then also here. So for the areas that are darker, I'm actually going in a few times with this color, and I'm adding a little bit of a little bit more pressure each time I go in. Using the lines that I can see from the nail dotting tool, I'm just gonna use that as a reference point and go in with the dark sepia lightly around them. Thank you. together. Lightly going in up here. Walnut brown to darken up some areas up here slightly. Okay, going back in with terracotta just to darken up a little bit of the edges of the ear. Payne's gray. Okay, so with Payne's gray, what I'm actually going to do is I'm turning the drawing upside down, and I'm actually going to concentrate right where the ear meets the head. I'm slowly going up into the rest of the ear and just darkening up a few areas. Still using Payne's Gray, darkening up the ear. Okay, so I'm going to concentrate on the loose hairs up above the ear here. Gonna go in with Nougat just up above the ear a bit to thicken up some of these spots. So now I'm jumping back in with Cinnamon, just up around the corner a bit here to start with. Can't quite see the little fur flyaways up here, but they're there. Just kind of loosely putting it in around the ear. And then I'm going to go in with Warm Gray 2. I'm just kind of adding it to the tips of the fur. Now I'm going to go in like Burnt Ochre and just add a little bit more color. Going in with Cold Gray 6. color will help before I put in black to darken up the fur here. Back in with terracotta just to get the color back here. I'm going to add manganese violet into this area, just a tiny touch of it. here. Want to go back in with burnt sienna just up here a tiny little bit. That is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm not adding black in at this time. I will go in with black at the very end, unless you want to add black in right now. That's totally up to you, but for me, myself, and I'm going to wait till the very, very end. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.